Greetings, my brothers and sisters in the EPC. Grace and peace to you in our Lord Jesus Christ. My name is Dean Weaver. I'm the new stated clerk of the EPC, although I suppose new is a relative term. I've been in the office of the General Assembly since January of 2021, but I didn't become your stated clerk until last summer after Jeff Jeremiah concluded his 15 years worth of faithful service. So this upcoming General Assembly in this June will be my first as your stated clerk. And it's for that reason that I wanted to bring you some updates about what you could expect going into our General Assembly the third week of June and what has just come out of our most recent national leadership team meetings. So I hope that you'll come and join us June 21 to 24 in Northville, Michigan at Ward EPC Church. Our theme this year is Recharge. I don't know about you, but I think all of us could probably use a little bit of recharging. But that comes from Acts chapter 1 and verse 8. But you will receive power when my Spirit comes upon you to be my witness in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. And of course, that's going to be our focus this year on how we can be God's witnesses. It's for that reason that the EPC was formed. The E in EPC is not just evangelical, it's evangelistic. It's evangelism, and we will be doubling down on the E and EPC and focusing on how each of our churches can have an evangelistic culture and how each and every one of us can practice evangelism in fulfilling the great commission of our Lord Jesus in Matthew chapter 28 and Acts 1 verses 6 through 8. So first of all, let's get down to business. We've been soliciting names for this, probably what will be a quarterly strategic video update. And thanks to teaching elder Brian Rhodes from Gulf South, we've landed on the dean's list. So that is going to be hopefully good news because everybody, I think, wants to end up on the dean's list, right? And we'll just go down through some things that we need to cover, bullet points of things to help you orient, in this case, going into our General Assembly. One quick update about our podcast, In All Things. If you haven't started listening to that yet, we hope that you will. You can find that on Spotify. You can find that on Apple Podcasts. You can get it off of our website. Every Friday, we drop a new episode. And we've been doing that for a couple of months now. We've had 23 episodes as of this recording with about 3,500 downloads as we interview staff in the Office of the General Assembly, EPC leaders and authors. It's information that will help you as you follow Jesus as a member of the Evangelical Presbyterian Church. So look for that podcast, In All Things, at your earliest possible convenience. But a few strategic items that the NLT wants you to be aware of as we go into this General Assembly so that you're prepared. And in the coming weeks, I will probably send out a video on each one of these in particular to go into a little greater detail so that you can be ramped up for our General Assembly together. The first is that we're changing, or we're proposing to change, the funding model by which our denomination supports the larger ministry of the church in the General Assembly. For most of our years, we functioned by a support basis called per member asking. A number of denominations have moved away from that, and we have been thinking about doing that for a couple of years now. General Assembly, just 2 years ago, created a committee to look at the culture of giving and generosity in our denomination. And over this last year, we've been having conversations and presentations about moving to what we will now call the percentage of income model versus the per member asking model. And again, I'll give you more details on that in a forthcoming video before we get to General Assembly. Another thing that we'll be doing is that as we work through our strategic priorities, and you may know embedded in our vision statement in the EPC, we have four strategic priorities. A global movement is one of them. And in global movement, we will be celebrating a brand new master plan on the part of our world outreach. Our world outreach staff and global workers have been working hard over the last number of months. We're required to come up with a new master plan every 3 to 5 years. It's been 6 years since we've last done that. And this is a fantastic plan that aligns us well with the EPC's founding as those who are called to go about doing the Great Commission. Both, of course, in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, but also in the ends of the earth. And that's what world outreach in terms of global movement helps us to focus on doing. So we'll be receiving receiving and voting on the new master plan for world outreach. Our Fraternal Relations Committee is going to recommend that we study our relationship with the WCRC, which is an ecumenical body that we've been a part of for a number of years. I'll give you more information on that coming forward. We're going to talk about a couple of new fraternal partners that we may want to enter into a relationship with, denominations much like ours in other places of the world. The National Leadership Team is recommending a moderator-appointed interim committee on a pastoral letter on racial lament and hope. Again, a pastoral letter on racial lament and hope. Those two biblical categories of lament and hope will help hopefully frame a letter. And we've gotten pastoral letters on all kinds of different subjects as well as position papers, but we've never addressed this particular issue. And we want to do it from a thoroughly biblical standpoint. So starting with those biblical categories of lament and hope will help us stay on track as a genuinely EPC pastoral letter on one of the most important issues of our day. Again, more on that in future videos coming in your direction. So that's a number of the things that we'll be doing, but overall, the thing I think you'll appreciate about this coming General Assembly is all four of our strategic priorities will be on display as pointing to this idea of evangelism and the Great Commission as being the one central big idea of the church. So whether it's a global movement, church planning, church health, or biblical leadership, all of those things are going to go to how we do evangelism, have evangelistic cultures in our churches and presbyteries, and how all of that helps us, enables us to do the Great Commission. Because if you look at the mission statement of the EPC, it begins with, we exist to carry out the Great Commission as Presbyterian, Evangelical, Reformed, and Missional churches. But it begins by we exist to carry out the Great Commission. And at this coming General Assembly, we're going to double down on just that. I look forward to seeing you at Ward Church the third week of June. Grace and peace be to you, and we'll see you then.